Subscribe to our channel and press the bell icon to never miss an update.
If you look at how organizations are being designed today, if you look at the way they organize themselves internally, you will see that it looks a bit like a boat.
There's more than 60% of the growth coming from being in the right place and less in doing things right. And remember how much effort we put in whipping our organizations into outperforming the competition when it is a lot easier to just move to the industry that's growing faster. This ability of being in the right place to catch the wind and how you plan to move to that spot that's gonna allow you to take the favorable wind. And once you're there, if you're good at getting there, you're much faster than the guys who got the wrong spot and are struggling to take advantage and to fight against the less favorable conditions.
Right now we have these HR heads and some business leaders out here completely mesmerized by what they're going to do. But when they go racing, which a whole bunch is going to do now, you'll see how they realize how racing really reflects life. The decisions you have to take, you have to respond with agility, you have to take decisions without all the possible information that you want, you have to re-navigate and re-set your course, yet keeping your eye on the final long-term goal that you have.
Today was not just a day sailing. It was a day of learning and being reminded of small but very fundamental managerial and leadership skills. There are moments when the boat seems to be tilting. Now you can either panic or you can actually move places so that you balance and go through that phase of little concern and despair. I realized also that in the corporate world, it's exactly what happens. There are moments when there are dips, there are challenges, and as a team, if we are able to rally together and we are able to actually change positions to just add that little support to the person or the group that needs that, I think we're in a much better place.
The bit that I liked about experiential learning compared to, let's say, a classroom would be here we see things in action too very close to what we would experience. Many times, for example, we would say, okay, this skill is a very essential quality for you to succeed. But there, in fact, the team got together, the team evaluated, the team decided this person can do it, and it was a wonderful success that we finally saw.
You learn a lot in terms of strategy in the sense choosing which course, which path to follow, decisions to take. So strategic decision where you do have to think about your skills, but at the same time, you have to think and then act quickly in order not to lose the moment. And then leadership. In sailing, you get people flat in terms of social structure, and they go by skills.
I think we take the roles of leadership, I mean, absolutely. The importance of coordination, even in a small team. And the, as I said before, the importance of specialized roles.
While the MBAs can teach you the knowledge, it's very, very important to develop your skills by doing things, and that's really what experiential learning is all about.
It is almost like a simulation, and what books don't teach, what our defensive behavior at work doesn't allow us to learn, this is what an experience away from work in a more neutral setting and a setting as exciting as sailing can do.
SDA Bocconi at large is a business school that relies a lot on experiential learning. Here at the Asia Center of SDA Bocconi, we have, I would say, a particularly amazing luck because we started with a white slate, first of all. At the same time, we are a little bit less structured also. We are smaller, which allows us to interact a lot, the staff with the students, with the faculty. So from there itself, we start with experiential learning. I think with the event today, we have shown that we go beyond that.